During a meeting organized by companies exporting to the US that was held in Kampala, it was revealed that the African Growth Opportunities Act is still a big success in Uganda, despite the tough economic times. Susan Muhwezi, the senior presidential advisor on AGOA, revealed despite the COVID-19 pandemic that affected all economies, Uganda's export to USA is 65%. This means the earnings also rose from US$3.4 million in 2020 to $5.7 million in 2021.
Because remember, we are just coming out of a pandemic. In the last 2 years, there weren't many exports. Yet, even during that time, Uganda registered an increase in exports, which is definitely very encouraging.
How did that happen? Because
I think Ugandans are survivors. They're innovative. I can only give credit to them, because even personally, I was amazed that we had an increase during those tough times.
I can start from 2018/19. We were doing about 1 million exports in terms of exports. Crafts and sanitary products. As you're aware, we have about over 6,000 plantains to export. So 2018/19, we had about 1 million exports. 2019-20, we have about 3.4 billion exports to export. Only a goal. And then 2021, we now have 5.1 million. And you can see the growth is about 66% of exports to the US in terms of. So that's what I can say.
It is against this background that officials are calling for the extension of the AGOA program beyond 2025, when the project is expected to end. More Ugandans have also been advised to embrace the AGOA so as to be able to export their products to the USA.
The US saw what AGOA had done for the African countries. Then they agreed to extend it to 10 years. So we are hopeful that even now it's registered more successes. Look, Uganda has oil, and the success of AGOA before were with those countries that were exporting oil and oil products. So I don't see how they will not listen to be able to the call to extend it beyond 2025. I'm hopeful. We'll continue speaking, we'll continue lobbying. That's why such breakfasts are there, so that they are able to see how many people are actually benefiting from this initiative.
Meanwhile, some of the people exporting through AGOA have expressed appreciation to the government of Uganda for such programs.
A good thing for us, and we need to take full advantage of it, but I'm afraid we really are not. It's frankly a bit disappointing that we have less than 50 companies participating. We really should have nearly 1,000 companies participating in export opportunities to the United States. It's a huge market. From increasing participation of that is a multifaceted kind of effort. I think, as I spoke earlier in my comments, I think we need active and consequential involvement by government agencies, from Export Promotions Board to make things easier to export, to UNBS to make it easier for companies to meet certification. Value-added processes, etc., also in the private sector, improving their quality, because what you produce for Chikugo and the local market is not going to be the same as what you produce for the international market.
AGOA is a piece of legislation that was approved by the U.S. Congress in May 2000 to assist the economies of sub-Saharan Africa and to improve economic relations between the U.S. and the region. Uganda is one of the 38 African countries that are eligible to duty-free and quota-free access to the U.S. market under AGOA, which covers over 6,000 products. Some of the products from Uganda include coffee, cotton, textiles, fish, apparel, dried fruits, leather, cocoa, spices, milk protein, essential oils and natural extract. Report by Rachel Nachwala for the news.